Over here on the bottom right-hand side is the zero emissions button. So we go in there and you see these 8 different options. On the top left-hand side is driving range. You can access this same readout on a switch in the steering wheel. What's it showing you? Essentially, your range that was displayed in the gauge cluster over here on a map. Okay. Now, as the gauge cluster updates the distance to empty meter, this halo will kind of shrink and grow with it. Now, going back to the previous menu, the hypermiler screen, some people say that. For me, it's just my geek screen. You look into here and essentially you know how much energy is being used at any point in time. Okay, so this is for the electric motor over here. If you're accelerating, it fills up that way, goes all the way up to 80. Remember, peak output is 80 kilowatts. And then, of course, if you're regenerating, it goes down here, down to 30. Okay, on to the right over here, it'll show you how much you're using from a climate control standpoint. And below that, all the other support systems inside the vehicle. Over here on the top right-hand side, very popular question. People always say, what does my AC heater have to do with range? Well, we tell you right here. If you turn on the climate control, you will lose 4 miles. So let's go ahead and do that right now. Notice it automatically updates. And you see the readout, how much energy is being used by the air conditioning system. Okay, so that's really nice. Over here, you have instantaneous fuel economy, or I guess not fuel, in this case, energy economy. Mm-hmm. If we're driving, this gauge here is a bar chart. It'll go up and down. And then that is stored historically. The nice thing about the Nissan Leaf is that it provides you the option of using a charging timer. Okay, what's the value there? Well, essentially, if you want to charge with off-peak rates, you don't have to come back out to your car at 9 at night. If you just go into set the timer, you pick the time you want. Let's say 9 at night is when off-peak rates start and wherever your home is. Mm-hmm. You assign the days, you go ahead and click off whichever ones you want, and you save the timer. Notice that it says it'll start charging at 9 p.m. on all these days. You say yes. So now when you come home at 5 p.m., you just plug in the car, go to bed. Next morning you wake up, it's going to be fully charged. Okay. Then next to that, works much the same way. When you're leaving, if you know what time you leave every day, you can actually preheat or pre-cool the car using grid energy as opposed to your own battery. So that's kind of an energy save in some ways.